The probability density function of a continuous random variable is given by f of x equal to y naught e raised to minus modulus of x for x between minus 10 to infinity. So with this, we have to find y naught, mean and variance. Now here, this is a probability density function. So according to the definition, the function f of x should be greater than or equal to 0 for all the values of x. And if you take the integration of this f of x between minus infinity to plus infinity dx, the value will be equal to 1. So here, accordingly, let us use the second condition to find the value of y naught. So if you take this condition, okay, now the limits are minus infinity to plus infinity. Now take the real line. It is minus infinity to plus infinity. Now, just see how the function is being defined here. Okay, so function is defined as f of x is equal to y naught e raised to minus mod x when x is between minus 10 to infinity. So that here you have to just take on the real line, take minus 10, which will be now between. So clearly we can see that according to the function given, it is now minus 10 is between minus infinity to 0, right? So here this is what happens on the real line. That means here according to the given function, between minus 10 to infinity, if you take any value of x, the function defined is y naught e raised to minus mod x. And other than this interval, for here you can just see minus infinity to minus 10, the function defined is 0. So here we'll divide this minus infinity to infinity as minus 10 to, that is minus infinity to minus 10, the value of the function is 0, and minus 10 to infinity, the value is y naught e raised to minus mod x dx equal to 1. Now here, this can be, y naught can be taken out, it's treated as a constant. Now here, between minus 10 to infinity, we have both positive and negative values. As it is modulus of x, you can see clearly here, modulus of x is plus x for x greater than 0, and it is minus x for x less than 0. We'll divide this interval minus 10 to infinity as negative and then positive. So at the point 0, we can see it can be divided. So that here for negative value, modulus of x can be written as minus x, so that it is e raised to minus of minus x, we'll get it as plus x. And for positive, modulus of x is x itself, so that we'll get it as e raised to minus x. Now let us integrate it. So integration of e raised to x is e raised to x, and integration of e raised to minus x is minus e raised to minus x. Now if you substitute the limit and simplify, the value of e raised to minus 10 is very nearer to 0, so we'll neglect it. So if you can see clearly in the bracket, we'll get it as 1 minus of minus 1 as plus 2. So that y naught into 2 equal to 1 means y naught is 1 by 2. Okay, so the same question may be asked, instead of y naught, they may ask it as k also. Now see, we have to find mean and variance. So mean is given by the definition x f of x, okay, integration of x f of x dx between minus infinity to plus infinity. Now f of x, the given function, is defined between minus infinity, minus 10 to infinity. Now clearly we can just say this function is odd because e raised to minus mod x is even, but x to the power any odd number is always an odd function only. Odd into even will give us always an odd function. So that straight away we can write the value of this as 0. So just do mention that x e raised to minus x is odd function. Now to check for odd and even, you can just use the concept f of minus x. If you are getting it as minus f of x, it is odd. And if you are getting it as plus f of x, it is even function. One more observation is, suppose if you have a function defined between minus a to, suppose if you are finding integration of f of x dx between minus a to plus a, the value can be written as 0 if this function f of x is odd. Suppose if this function is even, the same integral can be written as 2 times 0 to a f of x dx. Okay, now let us find one more quantity, that is variance. So variance v is given by the formula integration x minus mu the whole square f of x dx between minus infinity to plus infinity. Now the same quantity, this is now like minus a to plus a, we can write it as 2 times 0 to a, that is 0 to infinity. Because you can see clearly now mu value is 0. So mu is 0, if I substitute, it becomes x square. Now f of x is even and x square is also even. So altogether x square f of x, if you take, it is going to be an even function. So that we have written it as 2 times. Now let us substitute the value of f of x. Now f of x is nothing but y naught into e raised to minus mod x. This is how it is defined. So y naught is written as half here, right? This 2 we have written as it is. Y naught value is half and then x square. So here you just clearly you can see 0 to infinity is a positive interval. So we are writing the value of mod x as x only. So the corresponding function is written as e raised to minus x. Okay. Now, this let us integrate it by parts. So we have to choose a function u whose derivative is going to be 0 after some steps. So x square derivative is 0 after some step. So this is our u. And remaining function is to be taken as v. We are aware of integration by parts. Keep the first function as it is, start integrating the second. So integration of e raised to minus x is minus e raised to minus x. Change the sign, minus. Differentiation of x square is 2x. Again, the integration of this minus e raised to minus x is plus e raised to minus x. Change the sign again, plus differentiation of 2x is 2 and integration of e raised to minus x is minus e raised to minus x. Next term, derivative of 2 is 0. So the integration process stops here. Let us substitute. Okay, the limits are here, 0 to infinity. Now, for the first two terms, for upper limit, e raised to minus infinity is 0. And lower limit, for x equal to 0, this x square and x term becomes 0. So that here you can clearly see the first two terms are going to vanish or they are 0. So you are left out with now the last term. Here, this is minus 1 cube means we'll take this minus up. It is minus 2. Upper limit e raised to minus infinity is 0 and e raised to 0 is 1. So if you just simplify, what remains in the bracket is minus 2 into minus 1. We'll get the answer for variance as 2. Okay. So this is about the examples on probability density function as well as probability distribution function. You can expect each, okay, in question paper, from each part, one question. Okay. Now let us summarize it. Okay. I'll give you the idea regarding this, what we have to study and all through this. You can say just a format. Okay. Now see, first thing, we have defined a random variable x, right? We have defined a random variable x. So if this x is taking some whole number value, we have called it as discrete random variable, isn't it? Discrete random variable. Now for any random variable, we can define some probability function on that. So if it is discrete, the function defined is called as probability distribution function. So what is main important thing here? Remember it as a summation quantity. So whenever we apply this PDF to calculate the probability values, we take the help of this summation. Okay. Now, there are two particular cases of this PDF what we have to study, that is binomial distribution and Poisson's distribution. The spelling is P-O-I-S-S-O-N, post P-S. Okay, Poisson's distribution. Okay, now whenever they give in the example, usually 95% of the question will be given what distribution to be used. So some cases they will not give it. How to identify? Suppose your x is taking some whole number value, you can take it at it is either binomial or poisson. Now, if the value of n, the number of times the experiment conducted, if it is less than or equal to 30, you can see, or maybe less than 30, then you can consider it as a binomial distribution example. When you are considering an experiment conducted more number of times, maybe like n greater than or equal to 30, so what distribution to be applied here is Poisson's distribution. Okay, this is regarding discrete. Similarly, suppose now this random variable x is not a whole number value. Means if this x is taking some rational, irrational, okay, like not a whole number value. Suppose if it is taking the value in the interval, then we call it as a continuous random variable. For even for this, we define a probability function called as probability density function. What is important here? Whenever we deal with probability density function, we use the integration. This is most important. Okay. Now, the two particular cases for our study are normal distribution and exponential distribution. Okay. Yes. Now, what we have is main important thing are the these conditions. Just you can see, for probability distribution function, all the probability values should be positive. And if you add all the probability values, the sum should be 1. This already we have seen. Similarly, for probability density function, your f of x value should be positive. And if you take the integration from minus infinity to plus infinity, that is should be equal to 1. You can clearly see the change over here. It is like summation is used. Here, integration is used. Okay. Try to distinguish when to use summation when we are dealing with discrete and like a whole number value, and when to take an integration if you are taking a value in some interval. Okay. Now, let us discuss about the first one, which is binomial distribution. Okay. So the word binomial, binomial is applicable like you have learned regarding when two things are there, two things. So here, suppose for an experiment, if there are two outcomes are there, if there are two outcomes, for example, okay, tossing of the coin. So if I'm interested in getting the head over there, so head getting a head is nothing but success for me. So what will be the failure? Getting the tail, isn't it? So whenever there are two outcomes like which you can take them as success and failure, or you can say those probability values are denoted as P and Q, then such a distribution is called as binomial distribution. Now, if you just see probability of success and probability of failure, if you add up, you can clearly see that the value comes out to be equal to 1, because probability of A plus probability of A bar is always equal to 1. Now, okay, along with this, we'll take some more things. What are they? We'll take it as N trials. N trials means this is the total, N is nothing but total number of times the experiment conducted. Okay, suppose we are tossing the coin 100 times. So N is nothing but 100. Okay, now, suppose I'm interested in getting the number of times the, that is probability of getting head, suppose. Okay, so probability of getting head, suppose I'm getting it for X number of times. So the value of X will be, now clearly it is between 0 to 100 for this experiment. Am I right? So you may get like in all the 100 cases, you may get it as tail only. So that time I can say X is 0. So one time I may get it as head, other 99 times it may be tail. These are the possibilities. So what it is now, X may take, now in all the 100 tosses, you may get it as always as head. That possibility also there. So if N is the total number of experiment conducted, x is nothing but getting that probability of success. Okay, so here this value will be from 0 to 100 if n is equal to 100. Now, suppose a distribution is defined like this. What is that? P of x is equal to ncx, p raised to x, q raised to n minus x. This is called as, this is a particular distribution. It's a probability distribution function named as binomial distribution. It is named as binomial distribution. Okay, now we have seen, we have defined a PDF, okay, a function, any function will be a PDF. If you apply a summation on that, the value comes out to be 1, which you can see it clearly. So this is summation of P of x. So we are just applying summation for this binomial distribution. Now for this binomial, if you apply, if you take a summation, so I'm just substituting the value of P of x. What is that? NCX, P raised to x, Q raised to n minus x. Now, x will take the value from, you can see, it is from 0 to 100 it is, because 100 number of times it is taken up. In general, you can take it as till n number. So x is varying from 0 to n now. Substitute n equal, x equal to 0. So where all x is there, take it as 0. So nc0 is 1, p raised to 0 is 1, q raised to n minus 0 is, so ultimately you are going to get it as q raised to n only as a first term. To get the second term, substitute x equal to 1, so that we'll get it as nc1, p raised to 1, q raised to n minus 1. Similarly, this is the next term when you put x equal to 2. Last term, put x equal to n. So this is ncn, the value is 1, p raised to n, q raised to n minus n, q raised to 0 is 1. Ultimately, you remain it as p raised to n. If you recall your binomial theorem, if you recall, this can be, just see, a plus b raised to n is a raised to n plus nc1 a raised to n minus 1 b plus nc2 a raised to n minus 2 into b square and so on plus b raised to n. This is binomial theorem, or it's a binomial expansion of a plus b raised to n. Okay, so this big thing can be written as a plus b raised to n. Similarly, you compare, this is just similar to what we have got over here. So according to that, we can write this big expansion as q plus p raised to n. We have seen that p plus q is 1. So the ultimately the answer you will get it as 1. That means this is also a PDF. And if you take in this format, it is called as binomial distribution. Now, for binomial distribution, mean is nothing but given by n into p, and variance is given by npq, so that standard deviation is root of npq. These are actual, there is a derivation, that part is not there for the syllabus, but you should be aware. So for a binomial distribution, mean is np, variance is npq. Okay? Yes.